Hi everyone, welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. My name is Adriana, and we're going to go ahead and dig into this new update that the Seestar ZWO has provided. And let's go into each one of these features one by one. First one here being Celestial Library has added four new star catalogs. I'm pretty excited about that. I thought that was really nice. We'll dig into that. GOTO is now permitted when the sun and the moon are below the horizon. Added a light pollution map card to the nearby module. We'll check that out. I know we already had a light pollution map in the app, but we will see exactly what they are talking about here. Now, some optimizations. There's an issue with histogram stretching that has been fixed. We will talk about that. I think many will be happy with that. Hopefully that has truly been corrected. There's also over sharpening of the moon that's been corrected. The stargazing mode now finally remembers the 4K setting. So now we don't have to go back in and choose 4K every single time. I guess it's going to stay there once you have it on. It's going to do that for all your imaging. So that's really good. And then added auto retry for failed GOTO target when you're doing your planning mode. So that's actually really good as well. Now you can just not worry about, did it grab my image while I was doing my plan mode? You know, when you leave your Seestar out at night, let it do its thing on its own, it'll auto retry whatever failed. So that's really good. Now they also updated user privacy agreement and SDK list. We'll talk about that. I think I know what they're referring to there. I'm curious what they did. If not, we'll have to ask Seestar for more information on that. And they fixed other known bugs. So let's go ahead and check this out. So let's start out with the four new star catalogs. Before I actually get into this really quick, what I want to say is I'm doing this on the S30, and just know that it doesn't matter whether it's your S50 or S30. The updates are good to go for both. But do know that what I've decided for this particular update in this instance is, and moving forward probably from now on, is I'm only going to update one device. So I have the app running on several other devices as well, or that can run on other devices as well. But I've decided, just in case I'm not happy with a certain new update or new feature, if I feel like it didn't work well for my benefit, or it's going to do something where something else messes up, I've decided to just do this update only on one app, on one of my devices. In particular, this is my tablet right now. So feel free to do that as well if you're a bit hesitant of updating to the new software update, but hopefully we'll be good with everything. The good thing is that they don't force updates anymore. You can choose to not allow the update, but let's see how this goes. And just remember that I'm saying that as a word of caution, because if this could actually result in issues where you have some devices running that are on the same network, the update, and then some devices are not. So just as a word of caution, it could cause issues, it could not. But I'm just going to, you know, on my end, I'm going to do it. So first thing, added four new star catalogs. Let's check that out. So I'm going to go to the Sky Atlas, click on Objects. And from what I see here, this is all the same. Deep Sky, Galaxy, Nebula, Cluster, Messier, Icy, and NGC. SH2 has always been there. Name Star has always been there as well. But this is new right here. You guys notice this? This is new. So I have also my other app open on the previous version so I can compare. Like I said, because I didn't update one of my other devices. And that's what I'm seeing that's new. So this Caldwell, RCW, VDB, and Planetary Nebula, which is pretty neat. Now, not that you couldn't find these objects before, you just had to do it the long route and do it on your own and look them up. But now it looks like we can type in some of these more obscure, I want to say, objects, and they'll pop up. You know, sometimes there were some objects that were not as popular, I guess you could say, that wouldn't pop up on your catalog. So now it looks like they're here. Check it out. Cat's Eye Nebula, Bowtie Nebula. So this is pretty neat that they did this. Blinking planetary. I'm glad that they did this. This is cool. So more countable objects there. RCW. I looked up RCW. It's referring to the Rogers, Campbell, and White Oak catalog, which is a list of emission nebulae and star-forming regions in the southern Milky Way. So now we've got the VDB catalog, and I looked that one up as well. This one says it's for a Vandenberg catalog of reflection nebulae. So it's a compilation of 159 reflection nebulae. I didn't know about this, so this is pretty cool that this is on here now. And now we have also planetary nebula added to the catalog. Blue Snowball. We've got all the good ones in here. So now it just seems like it's a little bit more organized. Helix Nebula, the Eye of God, even has the other names for some of these. Bug Nebula, Butterfly Nebula. I like that they did that. Because some of these just have more than one name and people refer to them as different things. So that's pretty cool. Sometimes we can't remember a certain designation for them, but we'll remember the other one. So I like that. That's pretty neat. Okay, now before I keep going here, I can already tell you that this right here in the top right corner is different. Usually this little moon is not yellow. So I guess now we're going to have some different looking emoji for the moon. Perhaps. So that's interesting. I wonder why they did that. And now this other feature regarding the GOTO being permitted. GOTO is now permitted when the sun and moon are below the horizon. I believe that has to do with an issue. I haven't tried it yet to see exactly, but I believe that has to do with an issue where the Seestar cannot find the sun or moon in EQ mode when you click on go to. So perhaps that issue has now been fixed. If you have tried it already on EQ mode and it's working, or you think it's a different kind of issue that's been fixed regarding that, let me know in the comments. Let me know what you think. Also, let me know what your favorite or not so favorite things of the update are. I'd like to know what everyone is thinking about this update. Now, another thing is it added a light pollution map, a light pollution map card to the nearby module. Let's see what that is. I know we had a light pollution map before. So under community, I'm going to click on LP map. A light pollution map card. Oh, I think that's it. I just kind of pressed. Okay, so you just press exactly a particular location that you're looking for. Oh, this is interesting. And I guess it'll tell you, I'm just going to click on a random location. It'll tell you the Bortle scale. Oh, that's neat. What's visible? Obvious M31, ground objects, Milky Way, only large structures. Your weather? Oh, that's okay. This could be useful, especially if you're just out in the middle of nowhere or driving far out from where you normally are. I like that. That's what they mean by a card, a map card. I like that. That's cool. Now, this other part of the update says it added or it fixed an issue with histogram stretching. Now, I believe this has to do with the issue that a lot of people were having or are having, where when you image objects for a long period of time, you're going to have it all of a sudden come out with different colors, like a bright, bright green, extreme greens, extreme purples or pinks after a long time of imaging. So it seems that it could have fixed that problem. And Seestar did mention not too long ago that issue would be fixed in the next update. So I believe that is. Now, also another good one, I like the fixed over-sharpening of the moon. Okay, I'm thinking that this over-sharpening of the moon has to do when we take a one-time picture, not stacking images. I could be wrong, but I think it might have to do with some people would say that when they just take one regular photo of the moon, it was over-sharpened. So perhaps that's it. Let me know in the comments what you guys think and if you've been able to see any difference in that Now, stargazing mode now remembers the 4K setting. Now, I guess Seestar is going to remember that it's 4K shouldn't come off anymore. So maybe once we leave it on 4K, it will know that and it won't turn off. So I'm going to leave that on so I can try it another time. Just leave on my 4K and make sure that that stays on and we don't have to turn it on every single time. Okay, so I'm doing Pleiades right now. And if you notice my 4K, I went to another object. My 4K stayed on. Now, under the advanced features, something that is new that I don't recall from before, telephoto RTSP address, wide angle RTSP address. So I believe this is for people who want to stream live. And I don't use this personally, but this is the S30. So I guess for the secondary camera and then for the regular camera, you can get an RTSP address. I do remember that people that were trying to use this before, though, those that do use it, like I said, I don't, but it would only do sun and moon, if I'm not mistaken, and it wouldn't let you live view, live stream the stargazing. So I don't know if that's what's now available, perhaps. Observing in real time, I looked this up and it mentions, ZWO actually mentioned what this is. They said it's designed to help some users who stream for that to be done smoothly. I'm going to turn it on. Not sure exactly also what that could bring. It says the current shooting time will be displayed in real time. Let's see. Oh, so this is the actual time right now. It is 9:59 p.m. Pacific time while I do this video. It's almost 10 p.m. and sure enough, 24-hour time clock here, military time, 21:59 p.m. Okay, that is interesting. Now, I heard that there is an assistant that's supposed to pop up on the screen, an AI assistant, where you could talk to it. And it will talk back to you. You can ask it or let it know where you want to. I think the goal is for users to be able to tell it to go to an object and it'll go to it. Apparently, people from the forum, what I'm reading, people are not very happy with this, but it's not coming out on mine. It is not coming out on mine. Clearly, I've done the update, but I don't see that on mine. Honestly, I'm fine with that because people seem to not be excited about it. They think it gets in the way of their imaging. Okay, so it appears that this feature somehow got taken off. I think they know that people are not happy with it. Perhaps they want to expand and work on it more before it's released again. I'm assuming that they will do that. Not only that, I think it could be a good thing for, let's say, people that are maybe more vision impaired as well, where you could maybe talk to it and tell it to go to an object. I think that's what the goal is for the AI assistant. I think it's not a bad thing. However, there should be some type of toggle that will allow us to be able to turn on or turn off. It was actually in your stargazing page and it was literally right in front in the way. So guess it's not there anymore. I guess that's really good. But let's see how ZWO continues to improve their software. And another thing I wanted to mention about the SDK list. So this is software development kit. I think they're finally acknowledging the Alpaca support is what I think whenever they mention this, but I would like to know, and ZWO, if you're listening, I would hope that you would take into consideration also allowing, let's say, us to be able to go into the ASI Air and be able to control our Seestar with the ASI Air. It still stays within your ecosystem as well, and that would be absolutely wonderful. We'd have more functions, more different for more, let's say, advanced users who want to try other things as well. And I think that would be a wonderful thing to add. I'm wondering now if it's added. Maybe I should try it to see if it's now compatible now with this update, since there might be now more programs or more software that can be used with the Seestar. That would be wonderful. But thanks again, ZWO, for the update. And we do get excited every time there is an update. The community just absolutely loves it. So thank you. And if you're loving this video, guys, make sure you hit the like button. And also, if you'd like to show your thanks, feel free to become a channel member. Hit the join button. See the description below. Or also, you can buy me a coffee. The link is right there. Feel free to check that out as well. I do appreciate everyone's support. Thanks to all of you, this channel continues to grow. Thank you so much. Check it out that right now on the Astro Room merch shop, the fourth wall shop, and I'm actually doing a special promotion where if you'd like to go ahead and get your Seestar cover now for a limited time only, everyone who is buying a Seestar cover now can choose a special superheroes deck of cards. These are licensed collectibles. They're really, really cool. And you can take your pick for whichever card for free that you would like to get, and I will add it to your order. I have several different options available, so feel free and check that out now while it's still available. Don't forget that this is for in between your sessions, so you can use it while you have your Seestar back inside the house, and that way let it be protected from dust, debris, and scratches. Thanks everyone for watching.